In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, it is very necessary that someone guides us and helps us to make decisions in life. Do whatever he tells you. This is what our Blessed Mother told the stewards, the servants, and is telling each and every one of us. A very apt and beautiful and meaningful advice to us as the Archdiocese celebrates Vocation Sunday today. Yes, we need to discern the vocation that we have. And sometimes it is the guidance and the help of the elders, those who are in charge, those who are guardians, to help us to make this decision. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare our hearts to celebrate this Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us now call to mind our sins and ask for the Lord's pardon and forgiveness. Together we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleas of your people and hasten and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I'll not be quiet, until her righteousness goes forth as brightness, and her salvation as a burning torch. The nations shall see your righteousness, and all the kings your glory. And you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem in the hand of your God. You shall no more be termed forsaken, and your land shall no more be termed desolate, but you shall be called My Delight is in her, and your land married, for the Lord delights in you, and your land shall be married. For as a young man marries a young woman, so shall your son marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices over the bride, so shall your God rejoice over you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response to the psalm is, tell among all the people the wonders of the Lord. Altogether, tell among all the people the wonders of the Lord. Or sing a new song to the Lord. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Or sing to the Lord, bless his name. Your response? Tell among all the people the wonder of the Lord. Proclaim his salvation day by day. Tell among the nation his glory and his wonders among all peoples. Your response? Tell among all the peoples the wonder of the Lord. Give the Lord your families of people. Give the Lord glory and power. Give the Lord the glory of his name. Your response? Yes. Tell among all the peoples the wonders of the Lord. Worship the Lord in holy splendor, or tremble before him. All the earth, say to nations, the Lord is King, he will judge the people in fairness. Your response? Tell among all the peoples the wonders of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit, and there are varieties of service, but the same Lord, and there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who empowers them all in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For to one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge, according to the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another the ability to distinguish between spirits, to another various kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. All these are empowered by one and the same Spirit, who apportions to each one individually as he wills. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. God has called us through the gospel to obtain the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, on the third day, there was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus also was invited to the wedding with his disciples. When the wine ran out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what does this have to do with me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the master of the feast." So they took it. When the master of the feast tasted it, the water now became wine, and did not know where it came from, although the servants who had drawn the water knew it. The master of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone gives the good wine first, and when people have drunk freely, then the poor wine. But you have kept the good wine until now." This, the first of his signs, Jesus did at Cana in Galilee, and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Do whatever he tells you. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, this is what our Blessed Mother advised the people. And this is what is very beautiful and an apt message for us today on Vocation Sunday. Now you may ask me, what is a vocation? A vocation means a call, a calling by our Lord for a way of life. We need to have and decide and discern, what am I doing and what is it that I am going to do? What is my vocation in life? Many a times we make decisions for our careers, a professional life, but we fail to make a decision for our lives in general. Where am I going to be? How am I going to live my life? A vocation is a call that the Lord gives us, asking us, what are you doing? What do you want to do? My dear brothers and sisters, every vocation has got 4 aspects. First, there is a calling, a call by God. It's very important, first of all, is to listen to a call. If we do not listen to the call, we do not know what to do about it. So first, we listen. We see in the scriptures, many personalities got their call. Be it Abraham, be it Moses, be it Samuel, be it even Mother Mary. All of them were called by God. And the second thing is, in a vocation, there is immediately a rejection or a denial of that call. How can I? I am not fit. I am not worthy. We see the example of Abraham. Abraham said, "Me, You want me to lead the nations, to take the people. I am far advanced in age. What am I going to do at this point? Even Moses faltered, and Moses said, the multitude of people, you want me to speak to them. I can't speak. He was stammering. Even Samuel was hesitant. We see how even Mother Mary was a bit hesitant in the beginning. How can that be possible, she said to the angel, when I'm still a virgin? Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, the second thing is immediately a rejection. But then comes the third aspect of a vocation, is an assurance by God. Do not worry, I am there with you. I just need your response. I just need you to say and reply to me for your call. Even Abraham was given an assurance. Moses was told that you have a worry about your speaking. Don't worry, I give you Aaron, your brother, who will speak for you. Even Mother Mary was told by the angel that the Lord has found favor with you. All is this, God gives us an assurance. And then comes the fourth aspect, my brothers and sisters, in the vocation. That is the mission. So after you have given your response, God gives you the mission. All of these people were given their mission, what they have to do. Lead the people. Moses had to take the people out of slavery into the promised land. Samuel was a prophet. We see John the Baptist was called to proclaim the good news. Mother Mary was the beautiful, most beautiful vocation, most beautiful mission, to be the mother of his only begotten son. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, these are the four things in a vocation. So whenever you're discerning, whenever you want to know what is my vocation, what is my calling, you have to sit for a moment, you have to reflect. First of all, listen to the call that the God gives you. Without listening, you cannot understand, you will not know. Listen to the call, then there may be a rejection, but God is always giving you an assurance. He is there with you if you say yes or no. He is guiding you. Don't worry, don't hesitate, don't worry about it. You give your yes, and then He entrusts you with the mission. My dear brothers and sisters, there are various vocations in life. The vocation to a married life, it is not simple. Sometimes people may say, I will see what to do. And they're so busy with careers and with life that they have no time to think about the vocation, about a vocation to commit themselves to each other, to commit themselves in a marriage. Then there is a vocation to a consecrated life, that you are not married, but yet you consecrate yourself to a holy life. Then another vocation is a vocation to the priesthood, or vocation to a religious life. Sometimes there may be a hesitation. What about all these things happening today? There is so much of persecution, so much of suffering. What will happen to me if I say yes to this vocation, to a priesthood or a religious life? How will I go about? You don't have to worry about it. Just give your response to God. Whether you are ready to offer yourself in service to the Lord will give you His assurance, His protection, His guidance. And we see how our Mother Mary is always there. And her message is even relevant today, the message she gave at the wedding feast at Cana. Do whatever He tells you. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, there is also the vocation to a single way of life. So whatever vocation you choose, you need to first reflect. You need to first pause and think for yourself. Ask yourself, how am I going to go about? What is God calling me to do? That, my dear brothers and sisters, is a vocation, a call from God. Unless you listen, you can't respond. That is very simple. And that is how our Lord Jesus Christ, along with His Blessed Mother, is helping us and guiding us. So today, on this Vocation Sunday, it's very important that you discern your vocation. Discern, reflect and see what God is calling you to do. If you have doubts, if you have any problems, you can approach your elders, you can approach the spiritual guides, you can approach the priests or the nuns or whoever you are trusting. Go and speak to them, but don't keep it within you or don't let it go away. Think about it. You have to listen. Listen, let your heart keep seeking. Listen to His constant speaking. Listen to the Spirit calling you. When you listen, what is your response? Let us now stand and profess our faith in God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting. Amen. Let us place our prayers and petitions before the Lord. Through this first miracle at Cana, Jesus gave us His first sign. Let us implore the Father for all our needs. Our response shall be, Lord, hear our prayer. Together. Lord,
our response, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our Holy Father Pope Francis, the bishops, the priests, and religious everywhere, that they may faithfully radiate your glory to all people by their exemplary lives and work. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all of us that you who have empowered with various gifts and talents, that we may use them willingly and joyfully for the good of the community. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our communities that you, Lord, enable us to understand and appreciate the differences that are found among us and yet remain united in your love. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all those who are preparing for matrimony, that keeping the spirit of understanding among them, they may have a happy and fulfilling married life. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we bring all these prayers and petitions before you and ask for your blessings. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Spirit's grace.
My dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by His birth He brought about renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by His suffering He cancelled out our sins. By His rising from the dead, He has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, He has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time He was betrayed and entered willingly into His passion, He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, He took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, He gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Understand the mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of His death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, you may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us your peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
You have prepared a table before me, and how precious is the chalice that I approach for my thirst. Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go announce the good news of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In His time.